exhale, send that right left leg across the body for an easy spinal twist. Again, arms come out to a T. Maybe gaze goes over the left shoulder here. Very slowly make your way back onto your back, hug both knees into the chest. And then start to take some big circles here, placing one hand onto each knee. You'll send the knees wide, and then they'll hug back into the body. Again, just massaging out the hips and the joints before we get into any active movement. Switch out your circles, take them in the opposite direction. Then go ahead and place your feet down to the floor. Knees stay bent. We're going to take some pelvic tilts here. So you're going to tuck the tailbone under so that the lower back imprints into the floor. And then exhale to release. You tuck tailbone under, lower back imprints into the floor, and then releases. Very small movement here, but bringing emphasis to the core before we get into more movements. Two more times, tuck tailbone, imprint lower back. Exhale to release. Last one, tuck tailbone and hold. Start to press into your feet, slowly lift the hips off of your mat, rolling up vertebra by vertebra until you get to the highest point. Squeeze the glutes, press the big heels, lift up a little bit higher, and then exhale, slowly roll down, going first through your middle back, your lower back, your hips hit the mat, and then your tailbone. Good. Noticing that roll up that you did and then that roll down. Tailbone tucks under. Lower back imprints into the floor. Start to press through the feet as you slowly roll up through the spine to come into your hip bridge. Hold here for a second. Imagine like you have a ball in between your inner thighs as you start to engage the inner hips. Exhale, slowly lower yourself down. Big exhale, breath out as you release all the way down. Remember, tailbone's the last thing that releases. One last time, tuck tailbone under. Slowly start to roll your hips up to your hip bridge. Squeeze your imaginary ball in between your inner thighs. And then walk your feet a little bit closer together as we transition it into some bridge marches. One knee is going to hug into the chest. Exhale, that foot comes down, and then you'll switch out to the other side. Continue to press your hands, your forearms, your shoulders into the mat as you transition one side to the next. Tailbone scoops under. Make sure that your core, your glutes are staying active here. And continue to switch from one side to the next, doing your best to keep your hips balanced and those hips as high as they were with both feet on the mat. Two more here. Inhale to exhale. Inhale to exhale. Last one, plant both feet down onto the floor. Slowly roll down through your spine. Hug both knees into the chest again. And we'll start to set up into a tabletop position with the legs. Knees are gonna stack over your hips. And your heels are going to come in line with your knees. So you create a half square with your legs. Most important here is going to imprint that lower back into the mat and making sure that your knees are stacked over your hips so that you start to feel this in your core. So just take arms out to the side. You're not invited to the party quite yet. Flex your ankle, your toes back towards your face. And then you'll slowly drop one heel down to the floor to tap. Exhale to bring it back up. Remember, tailbone is slightly tucked under as you transition one leg to the next. Lower back imprints into your mat. You're reaching your heel as far forward as you can, and then even slower, lifting that leg back to reverse tabletop. Remember, knees stay in that 90-degree angle as you transition here. Option if you'd like, you can curl head, neck, and shoulders up and look down at your belly button. Hands can come behind the head to support as you continue here. Four more. tabletop. If your head, neck, and shoulders were lifted before, give it a try here with that double heel tap. Three more. Breathing it out. Inhale as you reach, reach, reach. Exhale, bringing knees back over the hips and then not any closer to stay in the work here. Two. Nice and slow. Last one. Heel tap. Hug knees into the chest and relax your head, neck, and shoulders down. Give yourself a little rock side to side. And then start to rock and roll yourself forward and back to make your way into tabletop. You'll cross at the ankles. Make your way so that your shoulders are stacked over your wrists and your hips over your knees. Already here, spread the fingers wide. Press into your mat to activate the upper arms, upper back. Good, gaze down to the floor as you create a nice long line of energy out from the top of your head to your tailbone. Then when you're ready, drop the belly, lift the chest on your inhale for cow face pose. Big exhale to round the spine and come into cat pose. Again, inhale, drop the belly, lift the chest. Inhale. Exhale to round the spine, cat pose. Three more times here. Feel free to add in any additional circles through the head. A moment here for you to just feel what you might feel in your body. Inhale as you come into cow face pose. And then exhale as you come into cat pose. Then come back to your neutral tabletop position. Curl your toes under and hover your knees off of your mat. Press into your hands and we're starting to fire up the body and the core. Holding here. Gaze down to the floor. Keep pressing into the mat. Big breath in. Exhale, breath out. One more time here. Inhale. Hovering tabletop. Exhale, downward facing dog. Sit your hips up and back and maybe start to pedal out the feet. Relax the head, look back towards your toes, your shins. Keep pressing into your hands, especially your thumb and your index finger as you send your hips even higher up towards the sky. Big breath in here. Big exhale, breath out. Go ahead and find some stillness here on your mat. We'll begin our float here. We're going to inhale, lift up.